Hello friends, welcome back to another episode, and in this video we'll be doing the unboxing of the Galaxy S8 Plus Coral Blue color. So the processor is the Exynos 8895 octa-core on the Indian variant, and the GPU is the Mali G71 MP20. On the front it has a gorgeous 6.2 inch Infinity display with a pixel density of 529 and an 84% screen to body ratio with a resolution of 1440x2960. On the back it has the heart rate sensor, the flash, the rear camera, a 12 megapixel dual focus camera, and a very oddly placed fingerprint scanner. It also has a 8 megapixel front camera or the selfie camera, which supports autofocus and a number of effects this time. The rear camera records video in 4K and it is 8.1 mm thick with 173 grams of weight. So let's quickly start with the unboxing process and see what's inside the box. So turning to the light side, it mentions the MRP to be 69,000 rupees, and it has the mobile phone, a travel adapter, ejection pin, stereo headset, USB connector. The coral blue color, Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus, the 64GB variant. So let's turn the box and see what specifications are mentioned. So it mentions a 15.81 cm full rectangle rounded corner quad HD plus super AMOLED screen, a dual megapixel 12 and 8 megapixel autofocus camera, water and dust resistant IP68, an iris scanner, 64GB of memory internal and 4GB of RAM. Wireless charging is supported, but you need to purchase the pad, either the later version, the last year, or the current new generation wireless charger. So let's quickly open the box and see what's inside. So quickly we'll be cutting through the seal. Let's bring in the knife. And here it goes. So on the battery part, it has a 3500 milliampere battery which is non-removable and supports fast charging. So here's the coral blue Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus. Let's pull it out and keep it aside, and let's see what are the contents inside the box. So firstly we get this SIM ejector tool or the ejector pin with along all the manuals, and secondly we have this travel adapter. So this time Samsung included a black adapter with all the variants of S8 Plus, and it is charged at the same level, 9 volt cross 1.67 amperes for fast charging. We also get this USB-C type OTG connector, so you can plug in this connector to your Galaxy S8 Plus and connect any USB device to the second end to transfer data between the device and the Galaxy S8 Plus. We also get this useful USB Type-C micro USB converter. So if you have some old chargers of Galaxy S7 Edge or previous generations, you can definitely use those chargers. So here's the USB Type-C cable. The cable is also black in color. So this is a very good step done by Samsung. I much appreciate it. I always wanted all these things since the Galaxy S2 and the Galaxy S3. Everything came in black if you bought a black phone. And this time Samsung finally converted everything to the black nature. And the most special thing, that is the most talked about thing, the AKG tuned headphones by Samsung. So I'll be testing the headphones and I'll be also posting my views about the headphones. So you can see here it is branded AKG and no Samsung branding on the headphones. So it has this tangle free cable which is very useful, as it provides a very easy way and it does not clusters around. So we get some ear tips also as per your ear cup size, so you can change accordingly. So let's keep everything aside and bring the Galaxy S8 Plus, the coral blue color, in picture. So let's remove the plastic. So removing the plastic, we have this beautiful gorgeous coral blue color Galaxy S8 Plus, and the color is very reflective in nature. And one thing which I am finding out over here is that in the Coral Blue Galaxy S7 Edge, the side rim over here was gold in color, which I thought was a very big add-on or a compliment to the coral blue color. But this time Samsung decided to go with this coral blue color theme only, and the side rims and the borders are also coral blue. So on the top we have the dual nano SIM tray or the hybrid SIM tray. On the right side we have the power button, while on the left we have the dedicated Bixby button, the virtual assistant by Samsung. On the bottom we have the headphone jack, the micro, the USB-C charging port and the speaker and the secondary mic. On the front we have the iris scanner, the selfie camera, 8 megapixel, and on the rear we have the rear 12 megapixel camera, fingerprint scanner and the heart rate sensor along with the flash. So we'll be quickly setting up the device and powering on to see how's the TouchWiz OS, which has been redefined in the Galaxy S8 and the Galaxy S8 Plus. So holding this beast in hand, I can say one thing, that it feels very comfortable. It is the most comfortable Galaxy Edge phone I have ever held in my hand. I thought that from the S6 Edge to the S7 Edge, they had improved a lot and they could not improve further. But to tell you that this feels the most comfortable phone to hold with such a big display, it is very easy to hold this phone from one hand only. So we'll be quickly going into the settings, and from settings to about phone to see which software version it is running. So the software version is Android 7.0 Nougat. I don't know why not 7.0.1, and the Samsung Experience version is 8.1. So quickly going back to the home screen, I've downloaded a number of applications, and if you swipe left you get this Bixby application which you can use, and I'll be posting a Bixby review. So let's open the camera, and the selfie camera seems to be the best camera I've used on a smartphone. The clarity is very good. Let's test the rear camera also in a quick test, and you can see the focus speed is very fast. I think it is much faster than the Galaxy S7 Edge. So we'll be quickly focusing from left to right. So quickly focusing on the camera, the charger, again this. So you can see that I'm moving it very fast, but still the focus of the rear camera is moving along with me. So it's an insane focus speed by the camera of Samsung Galaxy S8 Plus. We'll also be seeing whether the pictures on zooming in distort because I'm clicking it very fast. Let's click and see how's the picture quality. So let's zoom in a little, and you can see that it is very clear. The adaptive fast charging comes out to be very clear. So the next image again. I did not even focus the camera much. I was a little bit shaky in my captures, but the results I am getting are very perfect. So you can expect some great quality pictures in daylight and indoors, whatever be the light conditions, and easily the best rated camera up till now on any smartphone. And it just feels so perfect to hold. So quickly I'll be seeing whether the always on display is switched on or not. No, the always on display is not on, so I'll be unlocking the device and we'll be quickly going into the settings menu to switch on the always on display. So we don't have it over here. And one more thing I will advise, that if you want full resolution, you should switch on the resolution to 1440x2960 rather than the shipped resolution. Content to show, only home button was seen over here. We'll be quickly applying the clock with the infinity wallpaper effect to see the gorgeous always on display on the S8 Plus. So here you can see the gorgeous infinity display in its full glory. I hope guys the video was helpful, and please check out my videos on the iris scanner review of the Galaxy S8 and the S8 Plus, and also a very useful tip of how to run games full screen on the Galaxy S8 and the S8 Plus. Do subscribe for more videos like this. Thank you so much. Stay connected.